Along with the announcements for the new MacBook Pros and the M1 Pro and the M1 Max chips, Apple quietly released an update to Final Cut Pro, and that's 10.6. Also, it updated Motion, Compressor, and iMovie. There's two major new features, object tracking and the cinematic mode for video. And that's video that comes from the iPhone 13, which allows for the focus to be adjusted in post. This video is a quick review of the object tracking, something that's been missing from Final Cut Pro and is long awaited. Object tracking in Final Cut Pro is simple to implement, but it does require you know where the settings are hidden. Let me show you. I'm going to have text follow the subject on the screen and also have a countdown timer follow a plane taking off. And finally, I'll show an easy way to pixelate and track a moving face. But just one word. You need macOS Big Sur and you also need to be running 10.6 update to Final Cut Pro. So let's look at the text following an object. I've dragged in a clip where a head moves around and hence will rotate the text as it follows. It's important that you know how to stabilize that rotation. To start, select the clip in the timeline and go to the Inspector's Film Strip tab. You'll see a new option at the bottom, Trackers, with a plus sign to the right. Click the plus. It'll default to automatic. And for this exercise, I'm not going to go into the other settings, but they will be in a future tutorial. In the viewer, there's a grid that can be adjusted. The top left changes to a circle shape. The orange dots resize the grid, and any outer edge will make it smaller. And the idea here is to get the size of the grid to just cover the object that you want to follow, without covering any background. Be aware though that the object you're tracking needs to be in frame for the whole clip, though it will allow for very short times out of view. At the top left of the viewer is Analyze. If you don't see it, click the Transform button. Click the word and the whole clip is analyzed. First forward from the position of the playhead and then back to the beginning of the clip. Now I'll add a title and link that to the Analyze clip. I'll use the custom title. Select it in the timeline and drag it to a suitable position in the viewer. Right-click in the viewer and select Transform. You'll see a new option at the top of the viewer. Click the downward chevron and select Object Track. The tracking information is now transferred to the title and you can play it. And note here that the text not only moves with the face, but it also rotates as the face does. And it's not obvious how to stop that, so you need to remember this step. Make sure you've got the title selected in the timeline with the Inspector Film Strip icon and have that selected and then hover to the right of Transform. You'll see a new button where rotation can be selected. Untick it as it comes on by default. Now you need to go back to the text and position it horizontally at the beginning of the clip, so it stays horizontal right throughout the clip. Next, I'll add the countdown graphic to that plane taking off. Click the tracker in the plane clip. Position the tracker on the end of the tail. Add the countdown generator, position it and select Object Track from above the viewer. And finally, I'll show you how easy it is to track a pixelated face without even having to select a tracker. Select Pixelate in the Effects browser and drag it over the face. It automatically recognizes it's a face and adds the grid just over the face. You don't have to resize it. All you have to do is analyze and play. and perhaps turn up pixelization. And that's all for this tutorial. I'm going to spend some time using the shape and the draw masks and see how they track with this object tracker. That'll be in the next tutorial, so please like, subscribe, and press the bell to be notified when that next tracking tutorial is published.